magbago na naman yung ano.
Eh, ang oras naman, ano, 4:45. Mag-banyo na kayo nang bago mag-type. 5
o'clock. May 5 o'clock
na sabi niya, mga nito. Ano? Mag-banyo. Kasi 5:20, 5:50 nang dating niya rito eh. Hello, men. Sa palagay ko sa'yo, magbanyo ka na para mataas yung party buwa kung mag-try. Ma! Masaya
to. Alam mo kung saan kaya rin
yung
ito
yung
saan
na pag-try? Saan? Sa Illinois. Oo. Hindi, okay, sige. Mag-ano na rin tayo. Kasi marami ng tao rito ang nag-buhay ko na sa'yo. Mag 30 minutes eh. Ano may?
Mamaya.
Salta ka. Ano?
Mamaya ako dito. Nagdugo na yung mga ito. Mami. Nag-dry na. Ito na. Ito na. Diga na mag-ibo.
Ano nga lang yung bala? Parang ba tao dyan? Ano may?
Ano hindi ako marami. Ano niya kung hindi siya
makain? Tigain niya kasi doon tayo ulit, baka dumumi ka na.
Wala na kinakain na niya
ulit. Bakit hindi ka magaligo?
Pagod tayo. Sa biyahe. Kaya mo na. Bukas na lang kayo mamalito bago umalit. Hindi tayo nagmamadaling
pa. Udas ka talaga. E pati naman ligo, problema mo. Samantalang ako, hindi ako naliligo.
Lika.
Mga kaibigan, si Rapon Jetta.
Get back to your hotels. Oh yeah, there they are. So right there, you guys. Those are actually the elk. If you look to your left right now, you can see the elk roaming around. Yeah. We're going to drive a little closer to them here in just a second. Yeah. I love how he says it again. Look, animal, and he's pointing at people. I'm like, man, you don't even know that dude. Like, what's wrong? What did he do to you? And I'm, oh, that's all good. But yeah, I appreciate you actually calling it out, man. All right. That's what I'm saying, you guys. I don't know why, for whatever reason, they love hanging around here. Again, I think it's because people feed them and they shouldn't. At one point, we actually had one of them actually feeding off a tree where the lady with the pink cap is. That's how close they were. All right. You can see them feeding. Okay. Remember, if you see the ones with the antlers and the big old donkey ears, those are mule deer. All right. Those are elk. All right. A little bit thicker fur around the neck areas. No, they're actually eating some of my life. Yeah. Alright.
Ayan po, dami nila.
Oh, thank you guys. You guys made my day. You guys all made it back alive and not hurt me. Except for one person back there, she felt the ice a little bit too hard. But don't worry, we have sweets to make it feel better. All right, you guys usually like to leave the park before sunset starts to happen. Right now, we are on track to be at In-N-Out Burger by the next 2 hours and about roughly 40 minutes. As long as traffic is clear the whole way, you're actually going to make great time. Okay, I'll keep everybody updated on as far as when we expect to be in Vegas. But remember, you guys, the bit of good news is that once you actually cross back into Nevada, you actually go 1 hour behind. So you get an extra hour. All right? Oh, what I was trying to tell you guys before, animals.
was like, what? He's here.
Yeah, they were really pressuring the sale, and I was like, dude, how many people here walk in like that much money?
Just a second, if you guys want to go ahead and get your cameras out, if you feel like taking a picture, it's going to be on the right hand side. All right, that one's going to go ahead and slow down enough for us to go ahead and take a couple of great shots. You guys ready? All right, here it comes. Ladies and gentlemen, Hoover Dam at night. Nice and close for you guys to take the shot to if you guys want to now. Good job, Kirk. Keep up the great work, Kirk. All right, you guys. Welcome back to Nevada. And just so you understand, that is the proper way to say the actual name of the state, Nevada, not Nevada, Nevada. You'd be surprised at how much I got yelled at for that one. It's Air Force Base, which is where it goes dark. To the right, at least. Alright. Now, I told you guys Henderson and Boulder City were known for like their minings. Pretty much conceived by a gentleman named Bugsy Siegel. He actually was sitting at the El Cortez Hotel in downtown Las Vegas. When literally he just had an epiphany of like, I want to have a whole bunch of hotels on one row together and one of them be a luxury. He had the very first idea for the luxury hotel, which is now the Flamingo Hotel. All right, you guys. Now you could actually sit at the very same bar Bugsy Siegel did when he had his epiphany to have to create the Strip. Now the name of the Strip itself actually wasn't his idea. That actually came from a former California police officer who moved to the city of Las Vegas. And basically, what is Las Vegas Boulevard to him actually just reminded him of the Sunset Strip. So he just called it the Strip. Make this please stop, let our people off. Now I want you guys to know that me and Daiwan, we actually do work on tips, you guys. So anything you guys feel like donating, we appreciate greatly. You can look through Vegas.com, and it does say basically beans, desserts, even really cool bars within there that actually do also serve food. Yep, that pyramid right there changing colors on the left, excuse me, your right. Is the Luxor. Now the one right next to it to the right, you guys we just passed it, was the Mandalay Bay. Mandalay Bay is a very nice, very chic hotel. It actually has a lot of cool stuff in it. I can't say too many good things about it just because I haven't stayed too much, but I will tell you they have one of the better nightclubs called Light. And even if you don't want to go into the nightclub, they have an awesome little section right in the middle of the casino where it's basically a bar and a huge dance floor. Save yourself the cover, go in there, party, and save your money. You know what I'm saying? Over to Bellagio with that little walkway over there. Same thing goes over here to the Flamingo / Cromwell. And also that's how you get to the link. Open bar, making yourself feel fantastic. Now this is the cheapest liquor store you can actually buy liquor and actually a couple of shots at. It's also a bar. All right, and Bautista's is right next to it. So after a nice dinner, don't get wasted. I'm just joking. All right, now this is a little known fact about Vegas, you guys. We understand that you made Vegas too hard. We actually have places where you can get an IV to revive you. Now without having to go to a doctor or anything like that, it's an actual place that is legally licensed to go ahead and actually put an IV in you. I will tell you though, they're about $200, but it will cure any of it and all of your partying, I guess, hangovers. All right. Now you guys, this is the Cromwell right here to your right. Essentially what you're looking at is, this has changed so many different times, but right now this is the number one spot to go to for the R&B rap, if that's what you love. Dre's nightclub is at the roof. There's the rooftop nightclub and bar here. Also, day club when it actually is summer. Some of the top acts in the industry come through here for sure. If it's a fight weekend, guaranteed, they have usually the Migos, maybe even Travis Scott. Like, they have some awesome entertainers come through here, if that's your taste in music. Flamingos, while you're in there walking around. It's kind of crazy. And apparently, Paula Abdul as well. Margaritaville is coming up right here. There's also an In-N-Out Burger in case you did fall in love with the animal fries right over here. So you guys to your left is obviously Caesar's Palace, but also Omnia. All right, Omnia is also one of the more popular nightclubs here. A lot of EDM DJs like to actually spin here. Calvin Harris, the actual chain smokers, stuff like that, like to make appearances. But they also like to go ahead and meet at Excess, which is actually right down the road at the Encore. All right. This little avenue right here to your right, you guys, this is actually something pretty new. It's pretty cool as well. You could do a lot of different things just right down this little road right here. At the end, it will lead you to the High Roller, but essentially there's nightclubs, bars, different types of varieties of bars too. You can check out different shows. And there is Jimmy Kimmel's Comedy Club. All right. To your left, you're gonna see those Forum Shops here at Caesars. Essentially, you guys, if you got the money, this is the high-end shopping area where you want to go. Just to let you know, if you're not willing to spend $500 on a purse, but you would like to go to an outlet, we have two different outlets, you guys, that you can go to, save a lot of money and still get great stuff. The North Outlets, which are right next to downtown, and the South Outlets, which are actually over there by heading toward the South Point, okay? The famous Mirage Volcano, you guys. This volcano here will activate usually about four times a night. The heat's coming from the flames. You can literally feel about a block down the road. All right, very intense. So you guys, we're gonna be stopping next at Treasure Island. This is gonna be a great place to get off if you wanna go to the Venetian, which is right here, all right? If you wanna go to the Mirage, if you wanna go to the Palazzo, all of that right here at TI when we go ahead and drop you off, just go ahead and head toward the walkways, okay?
Dito pala masarap tumayo.
Din?
Yan, may dito.
Tomorrow on her birthday.